Ohio State starts the season ranked number 16.
Being in the top 25 preseason polls is worth about as much as the paper it's written on. It's a long road to the Final Four, and this team needs to get out of the blocks quickly.
And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
Hey, Brad, we should really pay attention to the matchup in the middle. These kids are really skilled and worth paying special attention to. Expect a big game for one, if not both of them.
We're set for the tip-off. And we begin with a tip-off of the first half. The Buckeyes are currently ranked number 16 in the nation, Dick.
I'll tell you the reason is their defense has been absolutely sensational. He wants it.
He's asking for it on the low block, and they don't get it to him. A little two-man action. Cross court. With the J. Nope. Number 44 receives the ball. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
On the outside. He just threw it out of bounds. Sinks the shot. Pushes it up. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. For two. Off the glass and no good. For three. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Number 44 picks up the foul. First personal foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Well, here we have a look at one of the sophomores for this team.
Well, Brad, he's still mature. If you're on the class, but it's about improvement day by day, year after year.
Misses the second. On the right side. Cross court. He uses the shot fake. Takes the jumper and score it. A great drive to the hoop right there, Dick.
When you drive with conviction, good things happen. Sometimes it's a basket, sometimes you get fouled.
Number 44 comes up with it. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. Goes up for two. Shots off the mark. Number 10 takes the pass for the bucket. Off the glass and no good. Pushes it up. He tries the three. Knocked it down. Moving it around the perimeter. The guy was open, but he's a fan. They're set to inbounds from the baseline. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
10 to shoot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. They're getting no good looks at the hoop tonight, Dick.
I don't know what they're doing, but they're squandering away all those easy looks underneath. Look at that spacing.
Tries for two. He hits the shot. You can just blink and this guy's already got 20 on you. This man is a scorer.
His coaching staff feels as though he's capable of leading the team in conference and scoring. Sometimes he gets in a groove and can score a bunch of points in a short period of time.
On the left side. In the lane. The missed shot. For two. Sinks it. They are really keeping the dogs at bay on D-Dick.
Hey, they got him frustrated.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. He bombs from outside. Goes up for two. You betcha. Cross court. As the chance persists.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
He shoots the jumper.
Oh, what a high riser. Great vision. The fans love it. What a terrific play.
Number 52 is charged with the foul. First personal foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. They have one of the toughest things to get in sports, experience. Experience is so important, Brad. See situations and knowing how to react to them correctly and quickly is a great, great thing.
He misses the second, rebounds it.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
About 5 minutes remaining. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
Tries a three. Jumper won't go. For the bucket. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. They'll work it around the arc. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
It is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
Working around the perimeter. Turnover committed by the senior. Number 33 takes the feed. About 4 minutes remaining and the slam. Now they work it around the perimeter. For two, off the mark. Defense has really stepped up.
They're taking over the tempo very nicely.
Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. Puts up the J. They're having a real tough time hitting from the floor.
Confidence has got to be an issue now, Brad. They aren't shooting the ball with any confidence whatsoever. It's Brick City, USF.
About 3 minutes remaining. On the left side. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For the bucket. And he can't hit the shot. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. He makes the shot.
Oh, dumped out.
Blocked. Two minutes left on the game clock. And they're whistled for a 10-second violation. The Buckeyes are moving the ball well. They're getting contributions from a number of players on both ends of the court, Dick.
You can't have any weak links out there at this level. The coaches and players are just too good, and they'll be exposed. So far, it's been a demonstration of teamwork here today.
Number 34 gets the pass. Blocked!
Up and inside!
For two. Off target. That's 10.
I haven't seen that in a while.
Lobs it.
He called for the oop, then went up and got it, baby.
The man can't escape.
Hey, Trapp's giving that kid some fits.
The small forward receives the ball. Goes up for two. Dick, if you ask me, they're not getting a whole lot of open looks tonight.
They're not moving the ball the way they were taught, Brad. Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
1 minute left to go. Way out on top, controlling the ball. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Knocks it down. For the bucket, off the glass and no good. Tries for two, off the glass and no good. For two, he gets the bucket. Pushes it up. He can't beat the trap.
Well done, great trap.
Out of bounds and a change of possession. In the post, he gets the rejection. Loose ball, kept in. And the ball out of bounds, but we'll be staying right here. They'll throw this one in from the side. He got it off in time. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Call this a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
At the end of the first half, the Buckeyes are ahead by five. Ohio State pulled down rebounds left and right in that first half, Dick.
That's right. They were beating their men in a spot to grab the rock. That's how you control the glass, man, and that's how you control the game.
Looks like a full-court man-to-man press, Mr. Vitale.
Want to get that ball movement, get that good
speed. He makes the block.
Nice rotation over, blocking that shot.
Goes up for two. Got it. He can put points up, and he can move the ball.
It doesn't matter if you're a scorer who passes well or a good passer who can score. There will always be a spot for you on a team.
And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
What a strip, Red. The Buckeyes pushing the ball in transition. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
The small forward takes the pass. Looking for a good shot. He puts up the tray. Missed the jumper. The point guard with the ball. Gave it up for the bucket. Great shot. Time to pick up the defense here now. Stolen away. On the dribble, gives it up. Here they go into transition. Number 23 is called for the foul. First team foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
The Buckeyes will step to the line for the first time. He makes it. Loose ball and bat it in. The small forward takes the feed. And it's knocked loose. They push it up on the break.
That's a good-looking bucket out of the transition, Brad.
Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
The fans in the arena are going mad.
Welcome to Columbus, Ohio, baby.
He goes up with it. Off the mark. And we're at the 8-minute mark. Tries for two. Gets it to fall. And they burn a timeout here. We'll have more NCAA coverage coming up in a moment. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. Number 44 steals the ball. The Buckeyes are on the run for two.
I tell you, what pressure. Look at him take the ball to the length of the court. No one stopped the basketball.
On the outside. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Nice. He rejects it. That one finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. And let's take a look at a player who's really having a good game here tonight.
Wow, he's really elevated his game. A big-time player, scoring the basketball, doing it all. Just a special player. And you know, he's great to watch.
He attempts a jump shot.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
He shoots from right of the circle. Can't get the shot to go. We're at the 7-minute mark. Number 52 with the foul. Second personal foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes the first shot. And he got them both. He shoots from the angle. Nails a sweet jumper. He tries. tries the jumper. Nails the jumper. Pushes it up. He shoots from the top of the circle. Missed it. Goes up for two. Makes it. Number 23 takes the feed. Number 23 is whistled for the foul. Second personal foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
That's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket. I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
You can't miss free throws, Dick. It's going to kill you somewhere down the line.
Well, you got to convert. That's the one thing, like football special situations, you got to be able to execute there.
Second shot, no good. We're at the six-minute mark for the bucket. Nope. He takes the board. Number four picks up the foul. Third team foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Misses the first. They haven't been able to put it in from the line all night.
Hey, this is how you win ball games, guys.
Makes the second shot. Side. They work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Too strong. Nick, are they being taken out of their game offensively?
Hey, they're taking themselves out of the game by rushing bad shots and not executing on offense.
Number 21 handles the pass. From the corner. Can't connect. Number 10 handles the feed. Five minutes left in the game clock.
Trying to go inside.
For two. Can't put it down. The point guard receives the ball. Gave it up. Goes up for two. He hits it. The small forward receives the pass. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Goes up with it. They don't seem to be getting any decent shot opportunities, Dick.
Because they're looking in the wrong places, Brad.
Pushing in transition. Number 44 is charged with the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Both free throws go. On the dribble, gives it up. The Buckeyes were quite capable of playing in the half court, so at this point, they'll be able to continue playing their style, Dick, with the goal of killing the clock.
Offensively, they must resist the temptation to shoot early in the shot clock, Brad. If they get an open look from 2 feet away from the basket, that's one thing. Otherwise, they need to be really selective.
He blocks the shot. Number 44 gets the pass. From beyond the arc. And score it. He can't let this guy have the uncontested shot.
He just got to dig in and play some D.
Another turnover.
You're not talking out for turnovers either.
Tries for two.
Terrific score off the fast break.
He comes away with it. The Buckeyes in attack mode. For two, off the glass and no good. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. Goes up for two. That one's off. They're just having a devil of a time getting good looks at the hole.
That's right, Brad. I haven't seen a whole lot of plays carried out and executed the way they should be.
He tries the three ball.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Looking for a good shot. Jumper. The missed shot. The small forward gets the ball.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Number 44 is called for the foul. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Dick.
You can't have any weak links out there at this level. The coaches and players are just too good, and they'll be exposed. So far, it's been a demonstration of teamwork here today.
Two minutes left on the game clock. Number 33 grabs it. Now in transition for the bucket. Gets it to go. Jumped in front to take it away. The Buckeyes are on the run. Puts up the tray. Missed the jumper. On the left side. The skip pass is picked off. Working it around the perimeter. From three-point range. Knocks it down. Time out on the floor, folks. More ESPN coverage coming up right after this. Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
With a deep shot from outside. And come up short. On the wing. Tries for two. He doesn't get the hoop. We're at the 1 minute mark. On the right side. He wants a three. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
Great job of using the bounce to get to the rim. Not too many defenses that can stop that move.
He shoots from the deep corner. They can't find the range right now behind the arc.
They should start looking elsewhere. Maybe try and get an easy one inside.
Bust the J. Pushes it up. He shoots from the corner. Long jumper won't go. He shoots from downtown. Jumper won't go. For two. Makes the shot. They work the perimeter. He tries to knock down the three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Number four takes it away. They are struggling from trifecta land so far.
Yeah, they're having serious trouble hitting the shot tonight, Brad. That's surprising for this team.
While we've got a moment here, Dick, let's take a look at our players of the game.
Hey, two great young players here. Both stepped up for their teams and made this game interesting.